for so many of these guys, it's you know, when you first get hurt and you don't really know what to do, you come out and you see the people playing who once were in your position where you're just hurt and you know, kind of timid, and you look at them and you go, oh, they're doing great. They're living on their own. They have a family. They look happy. And that's, you know, the first moment. I mean, for me, that was the first moment when I looked at someone who was in my position, you know, 10 years before something. That's the first moment I went, oh, okay, it's going to be fine. It's going to take some effort and hard work, but everything's going to be fine. And I mean, that's what wheelchair rugby does. It's just so much more than a sport. There's so much of a bigger picture than just a sport and a competitive aspect. I think my top sport memory would probably have to be winning gold medal in Beijing in the Olympics. The thing that really stands out in my mind the most is at like 2 minutes and 11 seconds, I think I looked up at the clock and I looked over at my teammate, Andy Cohn, and he was doing the same thing, and we both kind of caught eyes and looked at each other and just kind of shook our heads, and it was like, you know, that's the first one we hit. You know, like, right, we're up by eight. There's only 2 minutes left. We're going to win this thing. I think I could easily say my goal is to win it.
Sure, plain and simple.
Plain and simple. People say, oh, you guys should, you know, you guys might get hurt or something. Two concussions, a broken arm, two cracked ribs, a slipped disc in the back over the past like 6 years. But, you know, I keep going out there. It's what I do. Just to roll around in a wheelchair doesn't mean I'm any less tough.